VTC Radio Detroit. You can find us on Facebook, YouTube, our website, www.wvtcradio.com, or download our WVTC app from the Play Store for Android users and the App Store for iPhone users.
You are tuned to WVTCRadio.com and the Sande Rose Show with your host, Sande Rose, where you'll hear the finest in gospel music and information you can use. The Sande Rose Show can be heard every Tuesday from 5 to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So get your pencil, paper, and your shouting shoes as you listen to today's broadcast. Why not text a friend and tell them to listen too?
God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds that thy hands have made, you stood somewhere behind the great, grand, and glorious hills of eternity. Rearrange your agenda for the creation of this vast universe. You reached down with your omnipotent hand into the great abyss of nothingness and threw nothing out into nowhere, and nothing became something. What a world we live in. Look at this world. It's gigantic and it's grand. Mountain heights with scintillating views, valleys scooped out by eternal hands, rolling prairies, running brooks, rippling streams blessed with gold, silver, diamonds, and all kinds of precious minerals. My soul sings when I look and see how God splashed a multitude of stars kissing the heavens like diamonds sprinkled against black velvet and hanging like trapezes from the roof of God's gymnasium. You placed the moon and announced for the world to hear, this is the queen of the night, and she has never stopped shining. The oceans, whose depths have to be measured in miles. The sun has never run out of gas. The stars keep coming out to play. The seasons still march in splendid succession. My God is real. He is from everlasting to everlasting. He even looked around one day to see what he had created and said, "That's good." And one day, when he brings everything to consummation and a glorious fruition, when he comes with a shout of acclamation to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart? When he calls me, I will answer. and I will bow in humble adoration, and my soul will say, how great thou art. For I know I have a house of many mansions, eternal in the heavens, up where Jesus lives, up beyond the atmosphere, the stratosphere, the exosphere, the troposphere, up where I'll never grow old, up to the streaks of gold, up beyond the vicissitudes of life. And I will honor him as King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and simply say to him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever, and forever and forever. My God, how great thou art.
Let us pray. I feel to pray at this time. I believe God. And I don't know, you may be on the verge. You know, there's suicide spirits that's following folks. You may be on the verge of suicide. Someone may be on the verge of swapping time for eternity. Someone, his body is racking with pain. Well, one may feel, well, El Hinton, that's going to always be. But it still don't stop us from praying. Father in heaven, as we pray and as we bombard heaven, as we grip the bell cord in Zion, the need is so great. But kind Savior, you're greater than the need. The sick, the suffering, the dying, the afflicted, the downhearted, the troubled mother, the troubled father, disturbed about their children. Oh God, marriage that's heading for the rocks, and everything they're doing within their power to steer it and turn it, but it's moving in that direction. Oh God, you said to call on you in the day of trouble, and you would deliver, and we would glorify you. Jesus, we need your help. Send thou help from the sanctuary and strengthen us out of Zion. You know our hearts, you know our needs, you know every heart. The churches that's in desperation, that's in destitute, the churches, some of them that the enemy is trying to fold up and close down, discourage leaders and pastors. Oh God, stir them and give them a new inspiration, give them new fortitude in times like these. For we know the enemy is fighting the faith of those that's endeavoring to do your will. Be unto us wisdom, and we'll thank you for it. Amen and amen.
Right, won't he work it? Will he work it out? Somebody ain't with us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Won't he do it? Yes, he will.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will. And we welcome everybody to the show today. This is the Sande Rose Show, and I am Sande Rose, and you are
Juliet Cooper. Hallelujah.
And we're glad to be in the service.
One yes.
More time. Because he didn't.
Glad to be alive. Hallelujah.
That's right. That's right. That's right. Just glad to be in the service one more time. He didn't have to let us live. So we're talking about all of that. All of that. All of that. But won't he work it out?
Won't he do it?
Won't he work it out? Won't he work it out? Amen. Amen. So how was your weekend since we haven't seen you?
My weekend was challenging, but it's got better. It was good, though. It was a good weekend, and then some things happened, but I'm all right. Everything is good.
All right. All right. So you're
back. He worked it out.
Okay. Won't he work it out?
He worked it completely out. Hallelujah.
Won't he work it out?
Uh-huh.
Yes, he will. And we have some people out here watching with us today. Nina Brown, we thank God for our faithful.
Yes, God, yes.
We don't take this lightly because we know you could be doing something else. And that's why we try to bring you good programming so that you will be spending your time wisely. Isn't that right, Juliet?
Yes, you will stick with us. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lena.
Amen. Stay
and
with
all our faithful crew.
That's right. Richard Darrell Nichols is watching. Tashana is watching.
Thank you.
Teresa.
You, Richard. Jackson. Thank you, Shana.
Carl Jackson. Amen. He said that song was fire. Yeah, it was classic fire. Yep, he'll work it out.
And yes.
Teresa wants to know, are you feeling much better over there, Juliet?
I am. Thank you. I appreciate you praying for me. I appreciate it. I felt your prayers. I got up today and I went to vote. I had to go back to my old neighborhood, way over there, but that's all right. I went.
So did you cast your vote?
I voted, huh?
You cast your vote?
I did. I wanted to see the names of the potential presidents on there so I could say no to one, yes to the other. And then I realized this is just the primary, girl. It's not going to be on here. So I got over that real quickly and moved on.
Oh, well.
Oh, yeah. I get a chance to do that in November. And at that time, I can go to my poll in my neighborhood.
Right. Because I don't know. I have a permanent absentee ballot status lately. But I don't know. I might have to walk in for this one.
Yeah, I think I'm going in. I decided to go on in. I'm going on in regardless. So I can make sure. Because it's nothing like putting it in the thing and letting it snatch it up. It's something about let it be counted. I like that feeling. Let it be counted.
Yes.
And making sure it's gone in there, Sandy. You need to make sure it's gone in there.
That's right. Well, I put mine in the box. So,
yeah. All right. Well, that's good.
They came on through. So, I put mine in the box. I made sure I checked everything, and there was no reason for anyone to spoil my ballot. And,
yeah.
So, we good to go.
That's good.
To go. Now, Roxy is out here. She's watching today. And I just want to know, Roxy, is it still hot there? She showed the temperatures in Arizona, And they were all, everyone was 100 and something for the whole.
Yeah, it's hot in Arizona.
I am mad because I like that kind
of. They have to have, my uncle lives in Vegas, and he has to have sprinkler system on his porch at the top so it spritzes him throughout the day.
I'm not mad. That's the kind of carrying on that I like.
Yeah, I would be furious. I know me. Not me. I can't stand to be hot.
Not me.
I don't understand nobody who likes that. It makes me angry.
Do you get a little angry?
Not like that.
Do you get angry?
I get angry.
I like it hot. I do. There was a movie out years ago and it says some like it hot, and that was me. I like it hot. Regina said that she just bolted.
Regina, I'm so glad she filled in yesterday for me. Look, and Jackie.
Yeah. Wasn't she a good fill-in?
She was a good fill-in. It was giving her shout out.
Right.
She had her own.
She had her own people. Amen. And you said, where is Jackie? And Jackie's away at the convention. So.
Oh, right. She goes every year. Okay.
This is her time.
Amen.
Yep, so we thank God Marilyn Burroughs is out here, Roxy, Kevin Peabody. I was about to send something out, APB, to find out where you were, Doc, but you...
He all right then, amen. Yeah,
surface, because he's mighty quiet over there, mighty quiet. Is watching. Gina said that her ballot got snatched, so she's happy about that.
That's right, Gina. It got snatched in that. I love it when it gets snatched in that machine. Then it takes a few minutes to get tabulated, and then it gives you a number.
Give you a number. Do you take the number to the marketplace?
Huh?
What was your number?
I have no idea.
See, you're supposed to look at the number and take it to the market.
I looked at it. To what market, girl?
To the corner store. Must I tell you anything more?
Oh, the market. Oh, the
marketplace.
I didn't know. I didn't realize that I should do that because I don't go to the marketplace really for anything. I need to start.
Yeah. I mean, every now and then you get, you know.
That's one to take to the marketplace. You're absolutely correct.
Right. And he says he likes it hot and he runs from the cold. Amen. He said he's got a new project. All right, Kevin. Well, you know we want it. Regina says she was 132.
Really?
Yeah, she says she was.
I wish I could remember that number. Oh.
I used to watch them all the time because I just wanted to know how many of my neighbors and people in my community had gone out, and that would give me some kind of indication as to whether the people were coming out or if, dang, they didn't show up for this one or whatever, you know. But this is one everybody, Lottie Dottie, and everybody needs to show up. Stop it. Inga said that 3 digits. You know what? You know, giving out numbers on this station. But if you get one.
That's my mama's hot thing. I know she knows what hers was. She working the poll today.
Oh, okay. And that gives you something to do. I like to see the seniors now Carmela said that she was only number 58, and I pray that you went at 7 or 8 this morning, because that's not a good sign.
Ooh, girl, I wish I could remember that. I think
that might have been a blessing.
Like, and I think it was a double digit, like that 177. It was something like that. Lord Jesus, I wish I could remember that.
It could have been your
ticket
out the
ghetto. Yeah. Girl, it wasn't going to be that because I wasn't going to do it like that. So.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Yeah, we are so glad that today's show, we have a special guest coming today, who is Mr. Lamar Campbell. And you saw that was his video in the beginning. Where he has a lot of popular music, and let me preface this. He has a lot of popular music. One of the songs that I'm going to play that is his has been viewed over 25 million times. All I want you to 25 million times. All I want you to do, please, ma'am, and please, sir, if you get knocked off, come on back. Because sometimes Facebook clowns, they don't care what kind of authorization you have. And, you know, they just clown on you sometimes. So just in case they clown on us today, I need everybody just come right on back. But I'm not going to play that song with the 25 million till way down into the show, because that's too risky.
It's probably my favorite song, too.
It could very well be. It's a whole lot of
people. It's probably my favorite. I'm going to tell him, as soon as he get on here, I'm going to tell him what my favorite is. It's because all the churches, well, at my church, all the loves church. It. And they fall out every time we sing it.
I fall out.
Every time we sing it.
Mm-mm. I fall out.
Me too, girl. Move I sing it and I fall out.
Every time they do it a lot over at Little Rock. And every time I'm like, I got my towel, and I'd be like, oh, God. And I'm just, I go straight in, honey.
I mean, but it's a love song to God. You can't help it. It's a love song to God. It's a blessing.
And it's God.
To God. I pray that he receives it the way I put it out to him. Because it's that kind of ministry. It's a full-scale ministry.
It is.
Full-scale ministry.
And I mean, you know, and just in case now,
yeah.
Carmela, now you got a good one, but that's not the one we're talking about. But that's a good one. We're gonna play that one too. But I'm telling you, he's got some songs, six-time stellar nominee. I need to find out who he lost to, because some of these songs are really, really good. So I don't know. We'll have to ask him, baby, why didn't you get Airborne Stellars? But we want to thank God.
And his first song that was a major hit, I gotta tell him when he get on there, when he gets here with us, though, because I went to see him, honey, with CC Winers. I've never been so disappointed. It was at Christmas, and they did Christmas songs. I was done. I was expecting him to sing his songs.
Who would do Christmas songs at Christmas time? Who would do that?
CC came out there singing Jingle Bells, and I was done, Artie. I laid down on the pew. The people in my section was cracking up, because you know how stupid I am. I laid down on the pew and said, no more Christmas songs. We want to hear Lamar Campbell. I can't believe I came here. I was at a white church. I can't believe I came here for this. This is terrible.
Would you say, child, them children that played the wrong songs, honey?
The people around me was cracking up. I was outdone. You hear me?
I know they were. But the bottom line, I know the feeling when you go to a concert and you're expecting... and it doesn't work out like that.
Honey,
that's not a good sign.
I know he remembers what I'm talking about. I'm gonna bring it up so he can talk. I know he'll remember exactly what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. I think I paid about $25 to see. I was like, no. No more singing of these Christmas songs.
Would you say no more singing? But that's what they'll do, because you know they have them little Christmas albums that they be trying to sell. So
yes,
yeah,
since he came out there, Jingle Bells. Jingle bells, I was like, girl, don't you jingle another bell in here.
I know it's December 24th, but
We I know it was cute, you know, but that's not what I was there for.
But they trying to sell them Christmas songs, I'm telling you. Yep, they trying to sell
songs.
So, hopefully, you know, I doesn't know. But we just want to make sure that when he comes here today, we're going to hear some great music. But all the music that we're going to play today is Lamar Campbell. But we want to make sure that, again, like I said, just in case, because Facebook gets a little witty sometimes, and just in case they do the chop chop, I want y'all to come back. They're not going to cut us off, then they won't cut you off, but you won't be able to comment. And so, Juliet?
It's like, yeah, okay, I'm good. I went right over the camera. I think I'm going to have to get another stand. It's not working.
Not working for you?
It's not working for me, no.
Not working for you. So, you know, I saw an article, and I'll talk about it when we come back. But this article, it asks what in the world is going on, because it was in the Free Press today about Straight Gate, and they had a crowd of people in church, and you didn't see any masks. I'm hoping that it was a tape. You know, an old tape that they were playing. But the Free Press didn't seem to think that. But
from days of old.
I'm hoping that it was an old tape from days of old, because they, you know, the people were packed kind of close to the front, and you didn't see a mask, so.
Oh, Lord. Maybe they hosed them down before they came in.
Get them in a bag. Maybe
they hosed them down and let them in. And hose them down on the way out. They did some kind of Holy Ghost miracle. You know, Straight Gate is, yeah, they do prophetic things over there. Maybe they did something like that.
Yeah, so maybe they dipped them in a vat of whatever. So.
Girl, they done something ridiculous over there. Girl, please, I can't believe it. I wouldn't have been in there. Oh, darny. They would have had to. Oh, they couldn't have paid me $1 million to sit up in there close like that.
Not going to do it.
I
have to.
Where's my life?
Nope.
I don't care who in there. You could have. The only way I would have done it is if they had approved to me that Jesus was there. And it would have had to been proof. That it was Jesus.
Proof.
Prove to me that it's Jesus.
Proof.
Before I get in there.
Because that's a mess.
Nuts.
That's a mess. That's a mess.
Who they just want? They just want to go to church. They want to go to church and die. What is going on with the people? What's wrong with them?
I don't know. So what you over there doing?
Me? I'm trying to.
I don't know. This at home is just not. It is. This at home is something.
It's the place to be.
Well, I like to be in the studio so I can watch you.
You ain't got to keep your eye on me. You keep your eye on yourself, honey.
I'm keeping my eye on Jesus, because he. To all of it. He is.
That's it.
To all of it. Yep. But as Richard says, you can't take the girl out of the country. Amen. Amen. So
what is Richard talking about?
Richard is talking about what Richard is talking about. So Richard Nichols?
As
they said, leave Richard alone. He got his own thing going on. And he's fine. Gail,
amen.
Yep, Gail is watching, and we want to say hello to Gail.
Hello, Gail.
Yep. So, I thought I had the picture that they show of Straight Gate, but maybe I don't. But it was a little something because I couldn't believe it. You know, but hopefully, like I said, hopefully it was, you know, they don't understand that you can play a tape and it's live.
Right.
And it'll show up that it's live, but it's actually a tape. So,
because I saw a church myself doing the same thing, and I said, this got to be a tape. I said, it cannot be anything that they're doing for real live. It has to be a tape.
Right. So hopefully, hopefully that's what it is. It's a tape, and you know, they kind of got it wrong. So
I know, right? So the Free Press is really saying that. The Free Press saying a lot. Did you see the article about the money?
Which money? It's a lot of money.
The federal money. The PPP.
What happened? Don't leave us.
They gave out this money to all the churches. I ain't gonna say all, but most of them. Uh-huh. All the big churches got this money. It's called Paycheck Protection. It's another P. Paycheck Protection something. So they offered it to all the churches, I think. But anyway, it was for you to check, protect your...
Yeah, for PPE equipment.
It's for your staff.
Right. So it says, it says Michigan churches, synagogues, mosques get millions in federal PPP loans. Paycheck Protection Program, right?
Yes, it's for you, and it's for you to pay your staff. If you pay your staff, you don't have to give it back.
Okay.
So if you don't, you got to get the money back. So some of them got up to $1 million, some of these churches. I'm not going to tell you who.
Free Press is telling you.
They tell you who got what, period. To the penny. You know, they don't tell you exactly what they got, but they tell you what neighborhood they're in.
Uh-huh.
Like, you know, Second Ave, Greater Grace. You know, they tell you what neighborhood they're in with money.
Uh-huh.
Third New Hope. Now, Third New Hope and Second Ave didn't get as much as Greater Grace and Triumph. Well, no, Greater Grace didn't get as much as, let me correct that. Greater Grace didn't get as much
Here it is. In the city of Detroit, some of the prominent churches in the African American community. Now, just to preface this, they talked about early on in this article, they talked about a lot of the Muslims and the Jewish community and all those people that got it too. So now I just got down to the part where we were interested in. And it's
now they really got a lot.
They got millions.
Yes.
Some of the prominent churches in African American community that got PPP loans between $150,000 to $300,000 are Greater Grace Temple on 7 Mile, Harper Memorial Baptist Church, Second Ebenezer Baptist Church, and Third New Hope Baptist Church. Triumph Church in Detroit got $350,000 to $1 million. They talked about the Muslim community. They got well over $1 million. They name all of the places, the Jewish, the Catholic archdiocese.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So a lot of people got a lot of money.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and it's supposed to pay, which does
$350,000 to $1 million.
Yeah. Which does not have to be paid back if certain rules are followed. are being given to businesses, nonprofits, and churches across the U.S. as part of the effort to help employers hurt economically by the coronavirus. The money is intended to pay for the salaries of employees and other costs. At least 75% of the loans must go toward payroll costs for the loans to be forgiven.
Mm-hmm. Is that something?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'm glad they got some money.
Me too. I mean, so that'll cut down on all the doors shutting. But it's a lot of churches that don't even have staff.
That got money?
No, they didn't get down. No, I talked to a pastor yesterday because I was trying to enlighten them and tell them, hey, you need to get some of that money if you can, you know. And she told me she don't even have staff. I don't even pay my staff like that. I only pay a sound man. I was like, child, bye. Right. But I ain't even get into it, you know, why fours, where fours, and how thou, none of that. But, you know, she said, well, it pays to pay them, don't it? I said, yeah, I do.
Yeah, I mean, it pays to pay them, but, you know, you want to make sure that you're doing the right thing and you're doing accounting by this, because that would mean that the people would have to get 1099.
Exactly, because she was reading it to me and saying what you have to have in order to do that.
Yeah, yep. Your people need to be getting 1099. And
right.
I know a lot of people is not talking about that. Kevin said it's the Paycheck Protection Program. He said the Catholic Church, that's the grant part, but there is a loan at 2.5 to be spent with American companies only.
Mm-hmm. Say that one more time.
The loan that they give out as well to be spent with American companies only.
Mm.
So I think we've got several areas, you know, where the people are actually getting money, and maybe it's a grant, maybe it's a loan, a forgivable loan. It sounds like a forgivable loan.
Yeah, it's a blessing. Yeah,
and Carmela said that the pastor, musicians, and the janitor are all staff. You're absolutely right.
They are.
That's staff.
It takes a lot to run a big church, and especially one that has church in 8 locations. That's a lot.
Even your parking lot people.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of behind the scenes. You got your website designers, you got the people who, you know, put the flyers out. You got, you know, it's several positions in the church that are paid positions.
If you do it in house, especially if you do it in house.
Yep. And it's a lot.
Or if you outsource, all of that is pertinent to your ministry.
Yeah, but even if you outsource it, you got to pay the outsourcer.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's all pertinent to your ministry.
So, you know, and even some of them, you know, that, Carmela said the church secretary, amen.
That becomes a chore. And some people, you know, it's a turnover. At least at my church it is. It's a turnover. That becomes a turnover because it's kind of hard to keep staff in there when, you know, it's just hard to keep staff like that.
Yep. And Lena said the sound person, the secretary, but it's a lot of people in the church, you know, again, security.
Yes.
You know.
And that's a mammoth task.
That's a mammoth security task.
That's mammoth. Yeah, when you're trying to protect that money and protect, yes, that's hard. That's hard to do.
Mm-hmm. And some people, you have to give them some so they won't take none. Did I say that?
You better give them something so they won't take none. You better give them a salary.
I'm mad at nobody, but I guess I am afraid. And I don't play with God. I don't play with that money. So
yeah, I'm scared of that too.
But yeah, honey, gotta get you where can't nobody else get you, baby.
Honey.
No, you been got when God gets you. So I don't even want they. Well, we can give you something. No, thank you, baby. I'm gonna let the Lord rain it down from heaven or something. No parts of that. I've seen
that's something else, ain't it?
Yep,
that's something to consider.
Right, and they said like the nursery workers, for you to get a teacher or a professional to just run the staff, let's say if it's at a larger church, you want to have a professional that's running, you know, the staff, and you might have auxiliary teachers around them, but the person that you put in charge, that's their job. They have to set up the schedule, they have to do all of this. This is more than volunteer. So there's a lot of things that go on in the church and a lot of jobs that go past being a volunteer.
You know? Yeah.
They go into give them a stipend, you know, just so that you'll feel like I need to do this all the time, you know.
Right. And see, my church went to our whole staff. My church took the kids out on buses to a to a whole nother facility to be taught while we had church so that they would feel all right about being where they were. Mm-hmm. You know, so that take planning and that take a whole entity to do. That takes security. That bus driving company, it's a bus company. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it takes several buses. So it takes security to be with them to go where they going. It take, you know, that's a lot to do. They got to be bonded. You sending people with your kids. You know, that's something else. It's a whole heap of
stuff. I can't have the situation where you come this week and maybe you come next week or I'm not feeling you this week. I need to have somebody that I know that's going to be there for
weeks. That's consistent. So the pastor don't have to do it himself.
Right. So you may end up having to pay that consistent person. So that, you know, it's a lot to go that goes into running a church. And whereas people think that all I need to do is get a musician and I get up here and dance around and we're good, we can take up an offering. All this is mine. I'm telling you. If you're going to play with anything else, but please don't play with the Lord, don't play with the church, don't play with none of that, because that's too scary. That's too, because he'll smite you.
Yeah.
Smite.
It's a mess. And then you got, you know, these are lives in your hands. These are lives, these are children, the people's children. It's a lot to this.
That's right.
You are totally responsible.
That's right. You are. And it's on you. And that's why they picked you, because of your expertise. They picked you because of your certifications that you already have. They picked you because of the classes that you've taken. A muzzle not the ox that treadeth out the corn. That means that if somebody is here working for you and they're doing a good job, don't let them not get something. You know, pay them, appreciate them. And you know, it's too many appreciations. So, you know, it's like now you got Cash App. So just Cash App the children. And you know, do what you need to do, but you know, people need to know. They need to know. So we're praying because just like but applying to ask for your tax records, and they're gonna, people have to understand as well, once you let the government come into your business like this, you need to understand if you dance to the music, you got to pay to the piper. So you may or may not want the government, because once they give you the money, they can tell you what to do with it, how to do it, and everything else. Everything else. So, you know, that's the way that is. So we're going to go. I'm waiting on our guest to pop in, and I wanted to play the song when I saw him here, but we don't see him yet. So let's move on.
Amen.
Amen. I spoke.
Amen and amen again.
Amen and amen again. Amen again. We have a lot of backseat drivers here, so we have to make sure. Yes, a lot of backseat drivers. Honey.
Do you?
Yeah. Yeah.
Girl, who's doing that?
A lot of drivers are in the backseat.
Oh.
Yeah, a lot of drivers are in the back seat. But what we're going to do now, he should be on. We're going to play this song, and hopefully he'll be on when the song is over. This is Lamar Campbell. It's About the Love. We'll be right back. This is the Gospel radio station right here in Detroit.
He's a wonderful artist.
We on. You haven't got too old yet. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's a praise fest. It's a celebration. It's about the love of Jesus.
Well, you have to make sure that it's over because you know y'all are fooling. Y'all are fooling. Next thing, one, two, and you be back into it. I love that song. I love that song. And we're so happy to have our special guest with us today, Lamar Campbell. I love this song. Why does she sound like Lori Perry? Do you know the Perry sisters?
Yes, I do. I do.
Yeah, she sounds like the Perry. Well, they want to know who is that singing.
Her name is Michelle Bonner. And Michelle Bonner. And she's still with the group. She's been with the group ever since the 40 voice choir. And I'm grateful to have some of the same lead singers that you hear from record to record. So I'm really blessed to have that. And it's cool to be with you today and hanging out with you both today. We're going to have a good time. I know because y'all been cutting up already. I've been peeping in on y'all now.
Honey, we trying to keep get the children in the churches paid, honey.
I see that. I said, well, y'all go ahead and take care of this little business.
We got to get the cheering paid, honey.
That's right.
Yeah, so we are so happy to have you. Welcome, welcome. They're saying welcome. They're online. They love you.
That is so awesome.
Yeah, they said she sounds blessed. Yeah.
She is blessed.
Only thing
better than listening to her sing is seeing her sing.
So now who sang did you see the first song?
Yes, I did.
Okay, who sings that?
Now that's Denise Clark, and she's actually from Detroit.
Okay.
Her maiden name was Marshall, so I don't know if you know any Marshalls. Yeah, but she's actually from Detroit. She's in Indianapolis now, but she was born in Detroit. So we got some Detroit blood in the mix.
Yeah. It's in the water here.
Oh, yeah.
Come here and get a sip, baby, and you
through. You know, every now and then you got to go get a sip.
Go dip in the pool. They said, have you been to the pool?
That's right.
Have you been dipped?
Have you been dipped? I like watching y'all because y'all have a lot of fun. And I know you've noticed that I've been peeping in on you every now and then when I get a chance.
Yeah,
because I think I hung out for a little while when you had Keith Frank.
So you know that's our brother, and you're our brother now.
I know that's right, because we go back and we have so many connections, and we've been going back and talking about all of that.
I'm gonna tell you where I first became acquainted with his music. I went to the homegoing service of Bishop Al Hobbs. And, I've been listening to the music, but I just never knew, who.
Right. And I've always known your name in gospel. I've always known your name in gospel radio. So, so we haven't had that. This is our official meeting.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you all, this was musically the best homegoing service I have ever been to. And, I've been to some homegoing.
I know you have.
But musically, this was the best one. There was Kathy Taylor was there, Byron Cage, Angela Spivey was there. The guy that sings Safety.
Oscar Williams, who wrote the song Mimi. Yeah.
Mimi Red.
Order My Steps.
In good voice.
Yes. Hit the note and hold the note. Don't just hit it. Hit it and hold it.
She hit it and held it. She said, what am I stepping? I said, you better say it, girl. But musically, and I remember this choir over on the side. And they were, I was with Carla Poindexter.
Yes.
And
yes.
I said, Carla, who is that? And she said, girl, that's Lamar Campbell. And I was like, well, listen.
No, she didn't say it like that. She said, baby, you don't. Baby. Now, that's how she said it. Now, do I know it? Yeah.
That's how she said it. But yeah. I mean, your choir was so tight. They did all of the background.
Yes.
And they did, you know, a few songs themselves because we were there Friday, well, you know, for the...
Yeah, 2 days. Yeah. And were you there? Did you remember the Pentecostal ambassadors? Yeah, they were there on the night before. Yeah.
It was all just... But whenever we went to Indianapolis, we always got a lot, you know, even for going for sugar services.
Right.
All of that. You just always got a lot from Indianapolis. And I think sometimes people sleep, you guys.
They do. And we, you know, because we cousins, we consider Detroit music and Chicago music. We admit we holding it down, St. Louis. We holding it down for the Midwest. And we don't always, Midwest don't always get the credit that we, you know, at some of the other coasts. But, you know, there's definitely some good gospel music going on in the Midwest.
It is. It is. And I'm telling you, I was moved by the service. And I don't know. I think it was another 8 or 9 hour funeral, you know. But we didn't care. We were just sitting there because it was, you know, it was just enjoyable. The music was there for you, you know. But I just really, 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 really enjoyed that. And I'm just impressed that you're here and we're glad to see you.
Well, I'm glad that you had me and I'm glad that, wow. You messing with me now, but actually, that's one of the last times. That I celebrated my birthday. He did
is
a
that
birthday
at the house because I see a lot.
Yes, on that white red couch. Yep, on the other side of the fireplace. Yeah.
Yep.
So we were celebrating my birthday.
Yeah. Yep. So Al the Bishop. And there'll never be another.
Oh no, no. I mean, and the things that it was not so much the things that he did. But it was the passion in which he did them. When I say somebody that really had passion for gospel music, passion for the industry, passion to see a gospel moving forward.
That's right.
You know, because we always had it, but the world is just catching up to know that, you know, because as far as I'm concerned, gospel music is the greatest music on the face of the earth.
It is the face of the earth. And what a lot of people don't understand is that this is an original American art form.
Oh, yeah.
It's not, we didn't get it from Europe. We didn't get it from anywhere else. It's right.
Right. Here. We don't understand it. But when we go overseas to other countries, it's just, we are like royalty. You know, people that don't even believe in God, because a lot of these countries, the churches are owned by the state and all that kind of stuff, and they don't really believe in God. But when it's a gospel concert in London or Denmark and other places like that, people pack it out because they love gospel music just like it's blues or it's jazz or anything like. They appreciate the art form, but the thing about it is, they go for the art form, but they don't leave out the same. They don't leave out the same. Gospel music has the power of Jesus Christ in it. And it's impossible for people to sit up under the anointing and leave out the same way. As a matter of fact, I have a testimony of somebody when I did a concert in Denmark. He said, I'm not a believer, But I do want to tell you this, that something happened in this room tonight. I know something happened, but I ain't trying to say I believe or anything. But years later, I'm telling you, years later, I got an email from this guy and said, he said, I had to find your email address and try to get this word to you that I am a believer now and I'm singing on the praise team. I'm talking about what God does through gospel music. That's why I do gospel music.
It's life-changing.
Yes, it is.
It's life-changing. It's just not...
It transcends the Whitfield... I sing in the Whitfield Company.
Oh, yeah.
And I've been singing in the Whitfield Company for 40 years, yes.
Oh, wow.
And we went to Spain, and it transcends even language barriers. And we began to sing Walk in the Light. These people didn't understand English, and we know they didn't. And they were sitting at our feet, and we began to sing Walk in the Light, Beautiful Light. And they started flicking Bics and lighters. They didn't know what that was. They just started flicking lighters as a result of what we were singing. So it transcends barriers. God moves.
We get ready to get started, it looks like.
He moves. No,
we will go.
And in spite of, honey, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure it out.
No.
You just gotta go and do what he commands you to do, and
he'll do the rest.
That'll preach right there. You know, if we just carry out our assignment, sometimes we look at while we're doing our assignment, we're looking for all of what we think should happen. But we're just responsible for doing our assignment,
our part,
and let God do the rest in his own time, too.
That's right. In his own time. And the scripture says that Paul planted and Apollos watered, but God gave the increase.
Yes,
so sometimes
sir.
We're there, yes, just ma'am. To put a seed there. We're just there to put a seed. And and we might be watering somebody's seed. We don't know what,
that's right.
What you need to do.
Planted the seed and called you back later, years later.
Yes.
Yep, years
but
later.
That's the beauty of God. And the thing, what sometimes we discredit that, you know, maybe we were the one that was responsible for planting the seed, you know, and because it doesn't look like we're seeing anything grow, you know, we could decide, well, I ain't plant no more over there because stuff don't grow over there. But, you know, God is in charge of that. So if you
time and then harvest.
Yes.
So a farmer doesn't plant his crop and say it didn't come up next week, I quit.
Yeah,
absolutely. You give it some time, and then you get a harvest.
Absolutely. Just like even when we get a prescription from the doctor that you got to go all 10 days. You know, some people want
to
take the first pill. This didn't do nothing, and don't take the rest.
I ain't taking no more.
Yeah. So, you know, it's a process. And I'm glad to be a part of the process.
Yep, we have some people that are talking to you. Richard Nichols said it was Bishop Hobbs' voice on radio WLTC.
WTLC, yes.
I listened to him and Miss Poindexter when he was at Ball State University.
Oh, wow. Wow. Al the Bishop Hobbs would come on with the Love Express, boarding the tracks of your mind. And Sugar would come on in the morning with, good morning, God, it's me again.
It's me
again. Like, oh God, you bringing me, told you we was gonna go way back when we started.
See, I knew her from backstage.
At the workshop, yeah.
That's right. And Carla was there. And
yes.
I mean, we all got to be just wonderful friends and family.
Oh, yeah.
Because we were from the Midwest.
They don't even tell jokes like that no more because they had to joke. I ain't heard no good jokes
like that. They had some of the good ones.
No, I ain't heard no good jokes like that in a while.
And people don't understand that what Al started it was a precursor to the Stellar Award, because Absolutely. He had the Gospel Music Excellence Award.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And they converted that over, you know, basically to the Stellar.
Now, so you're telling it now.
There. Yep. It started there. So don't play with me. I know I was there. Don't play.
Okay.
Teresa said it's like Mick Jagger in Aretha Franklin's Amazing Grace. There's something about gospel music that'll draw you.
That's absolutely correct. That's absolutely correct. And just when you get to a period where you feel like maybe you want to give up on gospel music, you know, you can't do it because it's blessing too many people. Sometimes it may not hit us the same way, but you know, there are people with different experiences that need to hear it a different way. And so we can't give up on it. We can't keep putting it down because it don't sound like what we grew up with and all that kind of stuff. Let's just let it keep evolving. But we have to be the foundation of people, of artists to help these younger artists
right.
be rooted and grounded in addition to the trends, yes. you know, because sometimes we get up in
the flavor, yes. original flavor, because
yes.
we know the architects of this music style.
Oh, Lord, yes.
You know, we were trained by the architects, the people who, because, you know, we had a lady on last week, and she integrated the school. And people think that happened 100 years ago and these people are dead and gone. Honey, no. And the architects, they not all gone.
No.
You know, you got your James Cleveland. You know, I mean, it's people who know, who knew Thomas Dorsey. Who
right.
knew all of these people.
And understood the struggle, understood the challenges, right. understood that they were paving the way for something greater. I mean, if gospel artists today would take the time to sit down and reflect on those artists that paved the way for us to be, when artists were going traveling and staying in people's homes because they couldn't stay in a hotel or having to go in the back door and all that kind of stuff. And now we get to go and stay in 5-star. We get to fly. We get to go first class and all of that.
They have to drive in a station wagon.
And we have the nerve to disrespect and discount what happened to make this possible. So, you know, I hope. You know, somebody's listening to this and this is, you know, it's sinking in that, you know, it took all of that for us to be where we are today.
All of that.
Yes, Lord.
All of that.
All of it.
All of it.
Yeah, and God knows I love Kurt Franklin, but it didn't start with Kurt Franklin. But Kurt Franklin sat at the feet too. A Georgia Mass, you know, that some people wonder how he was able to do. But he's rooted. He can sit down at the piano and play a hymn. He can do all that stuff.
But
he grew up in that.
Rodina yeah. Preston.
Oh, yes.
Come on. He'll tell you, Rodina Preston gave him his opportunity.
Absolutely.
So, you know, it all goes back to, you know, these pioneers and that group of people. And I don't think we give them enough accolades. We don't give them enough reverence. We don't give them enough respect because they paid for this with their life.
That's right. Absolutely.
They paid for it with their life. And
absolutely.
I mean, you know, they probably could have been big somewhere else because I know there were a few artists that were here and they stayed with gospel.
Yeah.
But Motown was like, come go with us.
Absolutely.
And they were like, no, I'm gonna stay with the Lord, you
Man.
Know, and we don't understand. Now I have one question here. They want to know, did you teach a song to the women of GMWA?
Yes.
Okay, I've taught,
and actually that song, if they're talking about the same song, is featured on my new project, Forever. And I taught it at the workshop and Melody Daniels sang it. I will praise his name forever.
Okay.
Yeah. So I've done several songs with the women.
Yeah. Well, Pam was there. So she said that there was a song you taught to the women of worship in GMWA.
That thing went bananas.
Have you ever recorded it? Yeah.
Yes. It's on this project and it's featuring Kathy Taylor singing on that. Yeah.
What?
Kathy, you I ain't gonna right stop till everybody is on the floor.
Oh no. Yeah. And once you get down there, I'm gonna drag you too.
I'm gonna drag you.
It's Forever What? What's the name of it? Forever What?
Forever. Yeah, it's called Forever.
With Kathy Taylor. Yes, Lord.
Yeah. So the whole, now we know you have a new project out and we'll play it. As a matter of fact, you want to play it now?
Sure. That'd be great.
Okay. So He's More Than That. This is brand new. Why don't you introduce the song for us?
Well, this song is called He's More Than That. And it was inspired to remind people during these times when we're going through this pandemic, when we're going through this thing, racial reconciliation, the police killing and the violence in our community, that even though all of this stuff is going around us and it's great, but we serve a God that's more than that. And yep, we have to remind ourselves in the midst of adversity that we've got somebody that we can call on and he's going to bring us through. My new song, He's More Than That.
All right. You're listening to WVTC, the gospel radio station right here in Detroit. We have Lamar Campbell and Juliet, and we'll be right back after the song. Enjoy this. Won't you?
Yes, sir.
You got it, and all he has to be, how he could be the king of glory and still take care of me. Provider. Yeah. Deliverer, he is able to do all things, but he's so much more, so much more. Savior, he is able to do all things, but he's more. I'm like, you know he's more. Anybody know he's more? More than you ever need. Hey, he's more. Let him be your doctor. He can cure your disease. But he's so much more. He's more. But he's so much more. Oh,
and you'll come back. Oh, put those hands together.
Oh, yeah. You know I got to come back now.
Nothing like coming back on the children, sneaking up on them from behind.
Oh, yeah.
Sneaking up on them. And I, say, I like that.
That's awesome. I say this in my concerts a lot of times when I come back in. I said, now, you know, I'm not, this ain't got nothing to do with being deep or none of that stuff, but this got to do with being a Black man. And we always got to do it one more time. More, when you think it's supposed to be over, we coming back one more time.
You gotta come back. You gotta come back. You got now. Juliet had one. She talked about she went to a concert, and I want her to tell you this, that she went to the what happened at the concert.
Honey, I went to the concert. I paid my good money because I've always loved you, Lamar. I've always loved you.
That's so awesome, and we've always been fans of the Whitfield Singers as well. As a matter of fact, you look so familiar. I feel like I've seen you before.
They say, but tell them what happened.
I went to this concert. You was with CC Winers. I know you remember this. It was at Christmas.
Oh yeah. That was actually our first tour. That was our first tour as our
It was on your Yes, it was. Mm-hmm. I said,
yes.
Lamar Campbell coming. I gathered my little Whitfield friends.
Did you gather them?
He gathered with me. I said, look here, I know he's gonna sing his songs. I go, and honey, CeCe opened up. I said, CeCe opening up. She gonna sing Christmas stuff. And maybe come on with his stuff. Honey, CeCe sang Christmas. And then she sang Christmas.
Jingle
and she came back with Christmas. Jingle bells. I said, oh my God. I laid down in the pew back there. The people was cracking up because I was laying down back there saying, no more songs. CeCe, no more songs, girl. I need him. His stuff. Could you not sing another Christmas song, please?
I know it's so
the people
time.
That were around, they were cracking up. I said, we want to hear Lamar Campbell. What are you doing?
You were so bad.
You know, because I'm so telling bad. You, and anybody.
And God knows we were so happy to be on that tour with CeCe Winers.
That's right.
You know, a lot, but we were. But it was a Christmas tour.
Release him. Let him go.
What'd you say? Free him from the back. Free him from the back.
You won't go. Loose him.
Loose him.
Let him go.
I was so thick to be tired, I laid down on the pew. The people around me, I ain't lying, the whole section was cracking up. I know y'all can see them laughing. I said, what are they doing? What are they doing to me? This is terrible. What's going on? It sounded good.
I'm gonna tell you, you're making me feel like when this pandemic is over, that we need to go to Detroit and sit in your living room and give you at least about 20 or 30 minutes of concert.
You need to give Lamar Campbell, honey.
Because you've already paid for it.
Worth my money because I was so through.
I got a panel right in here.
Oh, okay.
Give me something, honey. Give me something.
So that was your first tour?
That was my first. That was our first tour with Lamar Campbell and Spirit of Praise. And
you had to sing Christmas songs.
And we had to sing, we had to do
it. I said, where is all about the love of Jesus? I ain't heard nothing of Lamar Campbell. It was terrible. When you walked out, I said, this cannot be. This can't be what he came to do. It can't be. He's coming back. I said, he's coming back, God. He got to be coming back for my... You were at a white church here. You remember? I know you
remember. Yes, I remember. That was the first... That was the first date of the tour. That was the
really?
First date.
Really?
And CeCe said, well,
okay.
I'm going to leave that
alone. Praise God.
Yeah, praise God.
Praise God.
Yeah.
But if you know, so now are you touring? I know nobody's doing anything right now.
No, but we hope to, you know, it's been so, we just did a Zoom thing on the day before the record came out, and well, it's digitally downloaded, but it felt so good. Just everybody, all the whole group was on the screen, and we were catching up with each other. I don't know if anybody else enjoyed it or not.
I know that's right.
But I believe that during this time, you know, God is really, I think once we get past this, that God is going to, when God opens up, we're going to have some powerful testimonies. We're going to have some reasons to get back out here on the road, touring and singing and ministering to people. And hopefully some of the hangups we had
pre-corona.
That post-pandemic, we won't bring into the
post-pandemic.
So
absolutely,
you know. And I just want to encourage people during this time to take some time to spend with God. You got time now, and you know He's downloading new ideas, new plans for things, that stuff that you thought about months ago that you never did, and let's take advantage of this time, because really this project that came out on the 24th, that was nowhere on the horizon. But yeah, you know, God put in my spirit, you know, over a span of two decades recording with Lamar Campbell and Spirit of Praise, that there's some songs on this out of about 100 songs that you've recorded, there's some songs that I want you to put together to specifically encourage people during this time. So that, and it all came together in about a month's time from the idea to being available. So you can't tell me what God can do.
Wow. Wow. And he can.
Yes, he can. I'm a witness.
I do know that this is a sacred time. And there's a lot of people, and our bishop told us early in the year, this was back in like January, December, he said the Lord is going to start saving people in the house.
Woo!
And I'll be doggone if I haven't, I got four friends who said that their children have been saved in the house.
Mm-mm. That's powerful.
Saved in the house.
That's so powerful. And this is what I said about, you know, there's some people that agree with me. It might be different for you, but it was something about the New Year's Eve going into the 2020. This year kind of felt like when we got into 2020, it still felt like 2019. And I was like, the first few months, I'm tired already. What is going on? But God knew that this time of rest was getting ready to come. He already knew.
And people don't understand, this is a time of rest, reflection,
yes,
and renewal.
Right.
You know, and you rest. You was passing yourself going in and out the door.
Yes.
You passing yourself. Yeah,
was I going in or was I coming out?
I'm telling you, I don't
feel the same.
Every day it was, you know, and now the Lord said, no. Be still.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're all still, and we're able to get that spiritual download, refresh our spirits, get brand new songs, get brand new.
And you know what's so cool? It is put, you know, for so long, we've had all these different playing fields to have to operate from. If you had this much money, you had to, you operate here. If you had this much, you in this class level, or you down here, whatever. But this put us all on the same level at the foot of the cross. And we all had to operate from right there.
That's right.
So, you know.
And then we've seen God change the hearts of people, because the protests and marches, that didn't just come up. God turned the hearts of people.
Yes.
During this, and it took this pandemic, because had they not been at home, they probably wouldn't have marched.
Absolutely.
Absolutely not.
All of it wouldn't happen. Work together for the good.
Yes. So,
you know.
Yeah, and look for the good. You know, before, you know, I've learned early on to, even though things don't feel good and don't feel right all the time, not to curse the process, because that very thing that you curse could be the thing that propels you into greatness.
What if Joseph had cursed the pit?
Woo.
What if Joseph had cursed the prison or Potiphar's house? Yes. All of that was a part of the process. And we have to go through this process. And I tell people every day, I have to be here to tell what happened.
That's right.
So I'm staying in the house. I'm staying safe. Yeah. I've been saying, I have to be the one to tell what happened. So,
well, we would say, when I lived in Houston, we said, we going to the house. We going to the house.
To the house, baby.
Yeah. We and stay in the house.
So now he said, they said, do you ever visit your high school, Broad Ripple?
Yes, I am Ripple Rocket. Yes, a proud Ripple Rocket. And as a matter of fact, the last year that it was open, which, you know, it's closed now, I was named the one of the important alumni of Broad Ripple.
Now, so, did they see it when you were in high school? Did you exhibit?
I didn't get it when I was in high school.
You didn't get it when you were there.
Actually, I got out of high school really quick, because that's when my music ministry was really taking off, and I was like, I got to get through this thing. And so I graduated in my junior year. So okay. I have two classes. I would call out those years, but if you're listening, you all know what they are.
I bet you my years is lower than yours.
Oh, no. Look at y'all, both of y'all looking.
They say he's a keeper.
Won't he do it?
Won't he will. Won't he will.
You got to be young, Lamar. You have to be.
Yeah, you
got
to be young.
I just told you I was in the Whitfield Company for 40 years, so you got to be young.
You got to be young. But I joined playing with James, so you got to be young.
I joined the Whitfield Company when I was 18 years old.
Well, I tell you this. I'm not 40 nothing.
Do I even remember?
Yeah, you know I ain't 30.
Do I remember anything about 40? All I can think about 49 is my 40 acres and a mule, and I think they about to give us something, so that would be appropriate.
That would be.
Isn't they gonna give us 40 acres and a mule, something? That girl.
That's what your mama want, her 40 acres and her mule.
Yeah.
That's what she wants.
It goes through the line. You know,
I can just see a mule walking down the street. Okay.
This is what you want.
I don't want no mule. You're gonna have to give me a horse. I want a prancer.
Oh.
I don't want no mule. I want a horse.
Oh yeah. You gotta have a mule. Gotta have a mule. Gotta have a mule. Everybody needs a mule. So now these songs. Are you the author of the song?
Lord bless, on this project, I wrote all of the songs on this collection of songs.
So now the song
is yours.
What's
that? I tell you what my favorite song is of yours that blessed me?
I bet you're gonna tell me.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell you. More Than Anything.
That song from the time we started teaching it in rehearsal. You know how when you've been in a recording choir before, you know how when you first start learning them songs, you already know what it's gonna do. That's one of those songs that even when I do workshops and stuff like that, I have to, and I still do workshops, workshops.
So did you say call them? You got a website?
Yes, LamarCampbell.com.
All right.
Yes, so even in when I have the time when I'm going to start doing that song, because it takes on a whole nother thing. So if I start with that, we may not be able to do the other
thing. Now, you wrote that?
Yeah.
You wrote that?
It was inspired by another song that I wrote, which is I Really Love You.
Yeah. So
to be able to
introduce
it to the world and for God to trust us with a song. He, God specifically told us to do music that helps put people in relationship with Jesus Christ. So with that mission, wouldn't it be just like God to allow us to have a song like that to teach the whole world to sing, I love you, Jesus, the whole world?
Listen, I was looking the song up, doing a little research.
Yeah.
I know it's 25 million. It's got to be 25 million. It's got to be at least 25 million.
And it's been redone. You know, Anita Wilson redid it.
Yeah.
Actually, they did it on a Kanye West Sunday service. And they have, you know, the young people. It's being picked up by a whole nother generation. This song is 2 decades old. So, you know.
Well, and, I'm sorry, but when they sing it at Little Rock. And when they say, I have to get my towel and I go straight in.
That's a
blessing. They sing it at Church.
That's a
blessing. At Tramp Church, it wipes the church out.
That is a blessing.
The whole church sings it. We sing in like a theater. And it's like, that's only one of the campuses. And the whole church just wipes, it's not a dry eye in the house.
Jesus.
It wipes the church.
I'm gonna play it, but I want everybody, when we play the song, I want everybody to sing it.
Oh, wow.
Sing along, I want everybody to sing it, but
it's amazing that everybody sings that song. It's not a dry eye in the house, and nobody's lips are.
If nobody's looking like I never heard this song.
We strike it up.
It's crazy.
No,
we saw my man sing it on Sunday Best a couple of weeks ago, and he did an awesome job singing it. But what was interesting to me is that when the band started playing the intro, you could see the audience already going up in worship. So
has oil all, yes. I mean, just took the oil and just poured it all over.
That's an oily song. That song is.
The Lord allows songs to come forth like that. And it's not a lot, but there are songs that come forth like that. And it's just, it just, go straight to your heart.
Yeah.
Straight to your heart.
And
I mean, I remember the first time I heard it, I was like, ooh, I love you.
It's a love song. Sing that without feeling
Now you said it's 2 decades old.
Yes. And it seems like there are more people singing it 20 years later than they were 20 years ago.
Yep, that's when the song has oil on it.
Yes.
Now it's hot now.
Yeah, it's a blessing. You know, I know when we get to heaven, we're going to sing a new song, and it's going to be a song that the angels can't sing. So we're going to have a whole another repertoire of music we're gonna sing over there, but I got a sneaky suspicion that might be one we get to carry.
That's
on.
That's gonna be one of them.
Carry on.
from this side.
Because I mean, think of it. It's just a worship.
Yes.
We get to heaven, what are we gonna do? Worship.
That's right.
You know, so it's a worship. Now, what inspires you?
What inspires me is, you know, as far as I can remember as a child, I would tell people around me and I would say to myself, God is going to use me, and not necessarily even God, but that I was going to do something to impact the world. At that time, I had no idea, you know, it would be music, anything like that. So, you know, God put in me at an early age the idea that I was supposed to do something to impact multitudes. And, you know, from a child, I've kept that same drive. My parents made sure we was in church. I tell this story all the time. I said, we went to church so much, we went to church to see if they was gonna have church. So just in case they had church, we already be there.
Honey.
So I thank God for my, my parents, my dad. You know, we talked about Sugar and Al. My dad would early on Sunday mornings cut that stereo all the way up and blast that gospel music.
Right.
And it was just a part of my DNA. So when I started, playing, because playing the piano brought me to the table. When I started playing the piano and then putting groups together and doing all that kind of stuff, there was such a call on my life to do it in excellence. From, you know, I didn't just want to get through it or just put something together. That has always been a part of that. So, you know, it's really been the whole journey. And I said this in another interview. My first group, I started my first group because of the song, a Detroit song, Expect a Miracle by the Clark Sisters, which we are celebrating the Clark Sisters. This is their season, another season for them.
Another season.
But I just thought, and you know, it was a group song. So I was like, well, I got to put together a group to do this. I was playing for choirs. So, you know, if it hadn't been for that song, I don't even know if I would have put the group together. And then when we started singing it, they asked us to sing more and more and more. I said, well, we got to learn some more songs because we can't. Yeah, so, you know, there's been a lot of influences and a lot of people that have inspired me down to
Now, is that the same group that you had all the time?
No. Actually, the first group was Lamar Campbell and Praise, which was a group of young ladies. And then the story is that, you know, when I did the first group and I did we released the album, it was the album, cassette, and CD. So it was the first year for CDs when that came out. So you had to have all three of them. So, so after I had high hopes, I had already picked out what I was going to wear to the Grammys and all that kind of stuff. And so when it didn't happen like that, you know, I was ready to be in the background. I'll play for you. I'll push me to write songs. I'm doing this project. I need you to write some. So I was very content with that. But then God called me out years later to start Spirit of Lamar Campbell and Spirit of Praise. And the rest is history. He blessed I was just being obedient. We had no idea that God would allow songs that flow through us that would bless people all over the world.
I'm looking at, you got One I Really Love You, that was 187,000 views. Power of Love, that was 31,000 views. There's Nothing Too Hard, 30,000 views. I mean, you know, it's the people are enjoying these songs. They're crying out for them.
And I want to say this, there's nothing, we have gotten so locked into what artistry looks like and what it's about until sometimes what we're seeing is just like, I've been taught that the music should always be bigger than the personality. And that's how God blessed us. That's like, we're just meeting, you know, all these years, but you know our music.
You know the music.
You know the name. God said it'll make your name great. So even if it does not look like all the Grammys sitting on my shelf or the Stellars and all the guys, even if, you know, I'm just glad that God used us in a way to touch people only in a way that we could do that.
Right.
And for me to say, because it doesn't look like that, to feel like I'm the small potatoes or whatever, you know, and I just want to encourage other people, you know, if we just do what God has assigned us to do and bless the people that are assigned to us, there's a group that he's assigned to each one of us. So what if I spent all the time trying to bless the people that was assigned to Kurt Franklin and the people that was assigned to me? I'm trying to do everything Kurt do.
No.
But it was some it's people that need what I gave you.
What you have.
Specifically.
Yeah.
You.
So.
You. And people that will receive.
Absolutely.
You know, some people can preach like Paul, you know, and it's like, I can't receive from them, you know, or that's not the one. Or and this guy over here is like, I listen, hang on every word. That's who God sent to bless me.
Absolutely.
So we have to understand there's a vineyard principle here. And unless you Jesus Jr., you didn't come for the world. He sent you for to bless some people.
Absolutely. And there's nothing wrong with not fitting in the box of what we say an artist should be, you know, or nothing wrong with us chasing ministry more than artistry and fame and fortune.
And more than a dollar.
Don't let people, you know, if God put something down in your heart for ministry, that's why I'm excited about this project. This ain't got nothing to do with trying to compete with nobody. This ain't got nothing to do with this. All this has to do with is obedience. You told me to do it, so it's and you use it however you want to use it.
And you will be blessed for that every single time. Anytime your obedience is better than sacrifice.
But even if you
word of God, and you Reverend, have to be obedient.
If you look back at Reverend Nick, C.A. Craig, James Cleveland, all those people, they didn't do it for the money. They never did it for the money. They wanted to get their songs out, their music out. They had this in here and they said, let me get it out.
Burning.
You know, it was burning. It was burning.
Yeah.
So it's a lot we can do. And you're on the right road. The Lord's got big things for you, and you have to remember too, when men speak highly of you all the time, then you got your reward. You are waiting on that WD, that well done.
The WD.
That WD. Yeah. I have some degrees, but I'm waiting on that WD.
WD.
That well done.
There you
and
go.
That's what we're all waiting on.
Yep. But I'm going to play this song.
We're still here. The pandemic has come and it's hopefully about to go. And yep. We're still here.
I'm going to play this song. And the Lord told me to tell the people to sing. Sing with the song in your house, wherever you hear this. I want you to sing. Open your mouth and sing with this song. Just open your mouth and sing with
it's
this song.
A love
we'll
song.
We'll be right back after this. This is WVTC, the gospel radio station right here in Detroit. We'll be right back with Lamar Campbell.
Yes.
Total adoration of to you reign on the throne, for you are God and God alone. Because of you my cloudy days are gone. I can sing to you this song. I just
gonna say that I love you more than anything. I lift my hands in total adoration to you. You reign on the throne, for you are God.
I love you, Jesus.
My God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. I love you, Jesus.
Yep.
Thank you,
Jesus. I do. I mean, that's a song.
Enough, God. I can't tell you enough.
That's a song. You done fogged up my glass. Thank you, Jesus. That's your name. If you didn't feel something with that song, you dead already. You're dead already. I mean, just something.
That's the one right there, guy.
Yeah,
yep. It's a lot of them, but that's one right there. I mean, I wanted to play so many more of your songs. As you see, my nose is just like, stop.
This is how God planned it. And this is how God planned it. You know, this worship and the conversation that we've had leading up to this worship, I'm just praying that God will use it to bless so many people.
Yeah.
And, you know, so many times we tune into stuff and we get more than what we expected. And I'm just praying that this is one of them kind of things when people watch this, it's going to be more than what they expected. And they watching for one reason and then ended up being blessed a whole nother kind of way. Thank you so much for you know, allowing this to happen. And you know, I appreciate that. I just call myself popping on the support one day, and you're like, oh, you're going to be on
You're not going to slide past him like that.
Yeah, so you don't know how much I appreciate that, especially during this time.
These people, they've got their hands raised, and I just want to tell you, you have not had a good shout and a good bump until you've done it in your house. It's one thing to do it in the streets, but when you've done it in your house, that's something. And you bless your entire house.
Yes, Lord.
Bless your entire house. So they're Michael, I can't hold my peace. They're glory. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
It's just, they just got their hands lifted up. Yes, Lord, I adore you more than anything. I lift my hands. They're doing what God wants. He wants our praises.
Yes, God.
He wants our praises.
Yes, God.
And that's what we were born to do, was to worship.
Yeah, he put the fact that he would put something inside of us that he desires.
That's right.
You know,
that's
right. That he desires. That's so awesome. And that's why we need to be intentional about moments we get to really give God all the praise, because, you know, that's just like a parent with a child. You have something you know your child wants and you withhold it. You know, God put something in us that he desires and he wants. And we have a decision to either give it to him or just withhold that.
I want to say, I thank God you did not sit on that song or any of these songs. I'm just glad that you didn't. And I feel like Regina now, he has to come back. He has more to bless us with. So you got to come back. We couldn't do it. And I know you have to go, and we're going to go off the air. But you got to come back, because we didn't even hit. I think we played about 4 or 5 songs. That's it. We didn't even hit the song, you know. But I'm just
thank you, God.
Grateful to God that your life, God. And for what you mean.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
You come back. I'm going to let her go on and praise, honey.
Yeah. Well, God bless you. You know,
And so we're going to go. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure that amongst all these praises that you go out and vote. It's not your privilege. It's your right. Go out and vote. Do what you need. We love you. We appreciate you. We thank you so much. If this broadcast has meant anything to you, please like and share this broadcast. If you felt something, give it to somebody else so that they might feel something as well. So we thank you again. Thank you, Lamar, for coming in. Again, we got to reschedule you. You got to come back.
I'd love to do it, and we'll make it happen. Thank you. This has been a blessing. God bless everybody that's watching. Appreciate you. Thank you for all the love.
Final words?
I just want to encourage people to hold on and keep the faith. You know, our God is more than that. Anything that you're facing, anything that you're going through, you plug into him. He's greater than any. If you can have it, he can heal it. We serve that kind of God.
That's good. If you can have it, he can heal it. I like that. Oh. So go home with that one. If you can have it, God can heal it. And he's a healer if the world don't believe it. Thank you so much, Lamar. Thank you, audience. And we want to say
thank you, Lamar. Thank you for the gift in you. And that's my thing on. Yeah. Thank you for the gift in you. And thank you for allowing God to use you the way he has.
God bless you.
Because I appreciate that. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
God bless you. Thank you so much.
We love you, Lord, more than anything. Night, night.
God bless.
Elder Rudolph Stanfield.
you for listening to The Sande Rose Show with your host, Sande Rose. If you have enjoyed this broadcast, won't you consider liking and sharing this with a friend or family member? We'd love for you to share it on your Facebook page. Thank you for tuning to WVTC Radio Detroit. Remember to like and share this broadcast with a friend. We are WVTC, winning victory through Christ.
WVTC Gospel Radio Detroit thanks the following supporters for their generous gifts of support to keep this station and these broadcasts coming your way. God bless you, we thank you, and we love you. This is WVTC Gospel Radio Detroit.